Do you want to use ChatGPT right in Excel without paying for Microsoft Copilot? Then this video is for you. I will show you how to create your own custom ChatGPT function in Excel, just like this one here. Here you just enter your prompt, select your input range, hit enter, and then you will get the result right in your spreadsheet. Now this works thanks to a new Excel add-in called xlwings lite. It runs Python and Excel without needing to install Python at all. And if you're not into coding, then don't worry. I have written already the code for you. So you can just copy and paste my code into your spreadsheet and then use the AI formula right away. So without further ado, let us dive in. Alright, to get started, just open a new or existing workbook. Then go to the Home tab and click on Add-ins. Here you want to search for xlwings lite. Once you find it, click on Add. Now a new task pane will show up. In this window you can now write Python code even if you don't have Python installed on your computer. So for a quick demo, I will just click on any cell here, then I click this button here, and then some Python code gets executed. Now it inserts Hello World into the cell and changes the background color. In my previous video, I explained this add-in in a lot more detail, so how it works, what the benefits are, and also some of the limitations. So in this video, I'm going to keep the explanation short. But if you're interested to learn more about this add-in, then check out my previous video. I will link it in the description box below and also in the info card above. Alright, so like I said, with this add-in, you can now write Python code. And that also means we could actually now send Excel data to OpenAI, so ChatGPT, and ask the AI anything we want. Then we can get back the result and insert it right in our spreadsheet. So to show you how that works, I have written some code for you. So first I'm gonna delete the sample code here and paste in my own. Then I will adjust the requirements since we need a couple of more packages here. Next, and this is also the only thing you need to do, is to insert your OpenAI API key. And you can get your key by following this link here. So just go to the OpenAI page and create an account if you haven't already. And then under the API keys, create a new key. You can give it also a name if you want. Once that is in place, click on create and you will have your key which you can now insert into Excel. Now just remember, the OpenAI API isn't free. So to use it, you need to have at least some balance in your account. For that, go to your settings, then under the billing section, make sure to add at least $5 as credit. Otherwise, you will get an error when you're trying out this solution. Alright, now with that said, back in Excel, you want to paste your API key right here. So if you do this, it looks something like this. Optionally, you can also change the model and adjust the temperature if you want. Now, once that is set up, you will have two new Excel formulas available. So if you type ask AI, you should now see two new formulas popping up here. Let me show you the first one, which is just running a simple prompt. This formula takes in two parameters. First, your prompt, and second, the input range. Now the input range can be just one cell or it can be multiple cells. If you select more than one cell, the code will go through each cell value, combines them into one text, and then send that text to the AI. But for this example, I will keep it simple, so I will just pick one cell here. So for my prompt, I will say that I want to translate this text into German and I only want the translation without any explanation. Once I have that, I will select my input range. Alright, and when I press enter, I will now see the result showing up right here. Now if you want, you can also copy this formula down. But just a heads up, that might take a little bit longer. That's because you're basically sending the same prompt for each and every cell, so one by one. But once it's done, you will get all the translations back. Now to make it a little bit faster, you could actually also send the entire range to the AI in one go, and then get back all the results at once and output them in the respective rows. For that I have written the run prompt list function. This function takes in a one-dimensional array as an input. That means it can be either one row horizontally or vertically. So just like before, I will write my prompt. And by the way, you can also combine it with any other cell, just like in regular Excel formula, to make it a little bit more dynamic. Next, for the items, I will select all the cells I want to send. Once I press enter, I will get a dynamic output. That means that the formula is only in the first cell, but the result will spill out into all the other cells automatically. And with that, we are now only making one API call to OpenAI instead of calling it separately for each and every cell. And this, of course, makes things a little bit faster. And since we linked it also to this cell here, if I update it, the formula will recalculate and we will get back the updated result. Of course, this is just one example. You could now use this formula for any kind of task you have in mind. Also see those kind of functions I created more like examples. So feel free to tweak them or use them as inspirations to build your own custom functions. That is totally up to you. Now, apart from the functions, I also created a script for you. The difference is, with the script, you can run your code using a button here. And the cool thing is that you will also have access to the full Excel object model. So you could do things like inserting new sheets, changing multiple cells at once, and so on and so forth. So to show you how that works, imagine I want to get the key insights from this sales report right here. For that, I have hardcoded my prompt directly into the code. And the prompt says, analyze the following table and summarize the key insight in a maximum of 2 sentences. Again, feel free to change this prompt however you like. But in my case, I will now just select the report and press this button here. Now the data, along with the prompt, will be sent to OpenAI, and the response will be shown up in a new worksheet. So here now, I'm just going to change the format of the output cell, and then I will copy the response to my clipboard. And then, back in the report, I will paste that right here. So let's have a quick look at the result. It says that 𝗌𝗘𝗦𝗖𝗥𝗜𝗣𝗧𝗜𝗢 generated 52 leads, closed 12 deals, and achieved X amount of revenue, which was below the target. Then it also lists the reasons for not hitting the target. So as we can see here, all the numbers and even the comments are all correct. Alright, and with that, let's have a quick look at the code itself, but as I mentioned earlier, I'm not going too deep into this here. So here in the small editor is our Python code. And as you have seen, with xlwings, you can define either your own functions or scripts. First, there's a run prompt function. This one goes through the input ranges you selected and combines the cell values. And then it sends that input along with your prompt to the OpenAI API and returns the result. Next, we have the run prompt list function. Now, this one only works with a one-dimensional list. Like before, it combines the values, but this time it creates a numbered list of the input. It then sends that list to OpenAI, and when the response comes back, it splits the result across multiple cells. Now, this isn't the most perfect or bulletproof approach, but again, it is meant as an example, so feel free to change it however you want. Alright, and at the bottom of the code here, you will also see a script. Now, this one works a little bit differently. Here, I'm converting actually the range into a pandas data frame. Then I turn that data frame into a markdown table and send it along with my prompt to OpenAI. Now, to show you what that looks like, I will print the markdown table to the output window. So, when I select my range and press the button again, you will see the markdown table appearing here. So, this is now the format we are going to send to OpenAI. And I just thought converting it to a markdown table made sense, because in my experience, large language models are really good at reading markdown. It is basically just text, but a little bit more structured. And also a little spoiler alert here, in the next video, I'm gonna show you how you can easily convert all kinds of Office documents like Excel files, Word documents, PowerPoint presentations, and so on into markdown. And then you could use those markdown files to train your own custom GPT. So if you don't want to miss that video, then definitely make sure to subscribe to the channel. Alright, and before we wrap up, one last thing. Right now, this code is saved inside the current workbook. And to show you what that means, I will save the workbook on my desktop and then I will close it. Now when I reopen it and click on the xlwings lite icon, you will see that the code is still there. So if you want to have access to my code, all you need to do is to install the xlwings lite add-in and download this file. You will find the link to this file in the description box below. And then, once you open it, you will see the code right here. Now, there's just one little downside that you need to keep in mind. If you want to run this code in all your other workbooks, you basically have to manually copy and paste the code into each and every workbook. So, for that reason, I also want to show you another solution. It is an Excel add-in that I created myself, and it's called My Toolbelt. Now, just to be super clear here, My Toolbelt has nothing to do with xlwings lite. In fact, this add-in is written entirely in VBA. So please don't get confused, it is basically just another option you might want to try out. And the good news is, there's also a free version available for this add-in. And you might have guessed it already, you will also find the download link to this add-in in the description box below. Now the big advantage of using the add-in is that you only install it once and it will be available across all your workbooks. Plus, it even comes with some extra cool features. However, the downside is, it currently only works with Windows and only with the desktop version of Excel. But if that is not an issue for you, let me quickly show you how it works. It is actually very similar to what we have done before. However, this time I'm gonna input my prompt directly into the cell. So in this example, I want to get the key insights in 1 sentence. And then I will select the data range and press the AI companion button. Alright, and now, just like before, the output will appear in a new sheet. Also, once the add-in is installed on your computer, you will get access to a new function called toolbelt_askAI. Now, this function has only one parameter, which is your prompt. So, that is the reason in this case here, I will just write my prompt all in one go, without any extra parameters. And once I hit enter, the request will be also sent to OpenAI, and I will get back the response right in the cell. And of course, just like before, I could also now copy down the formula. Also, if I change my input here, the cells will automatically update. And just like the other method, you will also need your own OpenAI API key to use the add-in. To enter your API key, you can go to the settings menu by clicking this icon here. Here you can paste in your API key, choose your model and adjust a few more other settings. Now these settings are actually saved directly on your computer, so they will stay the same across every workbook. Alright, so of course, this was just one quick intro to the AI Companion feature. In the description, I will also link two other videos I made earlier. Those go into much more detail on how to install the add-in and explore all the different kind of features. Alright, and with that said, we are at the end of the video. Now, lastly, I would really love to hear what kind of use cases you have in mind for AI in Excel. So drop your ideas in the comments. As always, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video.